Buff, I want to thank the Ethics Commissioner for his report. And even though I disagree with some of his conclusions, I fully accept this report and take responsibility.
Hey, I'm Warren Kinsella and welcome to the War Room. This week, we're talking about, obviously, the SNC-Lavalin scandal, the lab scam scandal, and I wanted to just do a little bit of a quiz off the top and get you to remember the name Joseph Welch. It's an important name. He had something to say about politics that speaks to us over the ages. I'm going to come back to that at the end. But somebody else had something to say this week, and that was the Ethics Commissioner. Here's what he had to say. The authority of the Prime Minister and his office was used to circumvent, undermine, and ultimately attempt to discredit the decision of the Director of Public Prosecutions, as well as the authority of Ms. Jody Wilson-Raybould as the Crown's Chief Law Officer, quote unquote. That sentence is of huge significance, and it has implications for all kinds of people, because this scandal is back. It's not dying. The first person that the report that sentence has implications for is Andrew Scheer, leader of the Conservative Party. When the lab scam scandal broke back in February, Scheer came out and said he thought that Justin Trudeau should resign. Some people, even within his own party, thought he had gone too far. Well, clearly he had not. Same thing goes for the lawsuit, this bogus lawsuit that Justin Trudeau brought against Scheer, for Scheer doing what he should be doing, which is telling the truth. That too has implications for the Conservative Party and Andrew Scheer. Another person the report has implications for, of course, is Jody Wilson-Raybould. Jody was the Minister of Justice for Canada, the Attorney General. Now she's running as an independent in Vancouver because Justin Trudeau kicked her out of the Liberal Party. He did that because she told the truth, or she tried to tell the truth. He wouldn't let her say everything that she had to say. Well, we now know that what she had to say was the truth, every word of it. And she showed more integrity and more courage than Justin Trudeau has been able to have in 10 lifetimes. The report has implications for the office of the Prime Minister of Canada. Justin Trudeau's most senior and influential aide, his best friend, Gerald Butts, resigned when the story broke a few months ago. Some of us weren't sure why Butts resigned. Well, now we know that he should have resigned, and he should bring with him Katie Telford, the Chief of Staff, Elder Marquez and Mathieu Bouchard, and Ben Chin. These are some of the staff people who were involved in this scandal. And Bouchard and Marquez are lawyers and should know better, and their conduct should be investigated by the law societies who have jurisdiction over them. Another group that the report should have implications for is the Mounties, the Royal Canadian Mounted Police. Wake up, guys, wake up. Have you been on an extended nap? We know, for example, that when Butts resigned, you seized his government-issued cell phone, you seized his government-issued laptop. But after that, we heard nothing. Total silence, radio silence. Well, now we need to get the RCMP focusing on what is a possible obstruction of justice, breach of trust, and a conspiracy. We don't know if those things actually took place, but we need the Mounties to investigate now. Another group that this report has implications for is the media. Susan Delacourt at the Toronto Star, Rosie Barton at CBC, Althea Raj at HuffPost. Those are examples of some of the media people who dismissed this story and denigrated Jody Wilson-Raybould and Jane Philpott, who also showed great courage by resigning her position in cabinet to support Jody Wilson-Raybould. Those reporters, those media who dismissed this story need to re-examine what they did and to go back at it and take a look at what they need to do in the future. Because clearly, this is a significant scandal, this is a significant problem, and they need to write it as such. They owe that obligation to their readers, they owe that obligation to the people who watch their shows. When I started off, I asked you a skill testing question about who is Joseph Welch. Joseph Welch, I can tell you, was a respected American lawyer, and he was in fact the lawyer for the U.S. Army during the McCarthy hearings in the 50s, when Senator McCarthy was going after communists and so-called subversives in places like the U.S. Army. Welch had heard enough, And I was reminded of him this week when I was watching Justin Trudeau respond to the Ethics Commissioner's report, where on the one hand, Trudeau was saying he accepted the report, and on the other hand, he was saying he rejected it. Here's what Welch had to say. It speaks to Justin Trudeau and it speaks to this issue. Quote, "Until this moment, sir, I think I have never really gauged your recklessness. You've done enough. Have you no sense of decency, sir? At long last, have you lost all sense of decency?" That's a question we can reasonably ask Justin Trudeau. Has he lost all sense of decency? If you feel, as I do, that Justin Trudeau has crossed a line, if you feel that he has harmed our democracy, you have an ability to deal with that. And that's the vote that is taking place in October. If you object to what has happened here in LavScan, the SNC-Lavalin scandal, you have an ability and you have an obligation to vote against Justin Trudeau. Let us know if you agree with me. Write to us, Facebook, Twitter. We appreciate you tuning in. I'm Warren Kinsella for The War Room.